الحمد لله الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. الحمد لله كما يحب ربنا ويرضى. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله بعثه الله رحمة للعالمين بشيرا ونذيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، respected brothers and sisters, Islam can be defined in a very short way as the religion of success, the deen of success. It is in fact the only way of life, the only religion that secures success in the dunya and in the akhirah. Not only in the akhirah, as many people think, but it brings success in the dunya. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, one element of success, or one important quality of success, that many people ignore, don't put attention to, unfortunately, especially the people living in the West, is to look after your parents. Now, many people might say, what has this to do with success? To look after your parents, what has this to do with success? And some people might say, in fact, we have seen so many people, and we see so many people who are successful, they don't know their parents. And remember what we said, that Islam secures success in the dunya and in the akhirah, in both lives. Many of those whom you see and you consider them as successful, especially for our youngsters, they might be successful in gaining wealth, in being rich, in finance only. But if you look at their life in general, we are not talking about their akhirah. Even in their life, you might find that they are facing so many social problems, so many spiritual problems. Many of those that we call as successful people, rich people, yeah, you know better than I do, they consume a lot of drugs. Why do they consume a lot of drugs? Because they are not happy. Money could not secure happiness for them. So that is not success. Maybe that is a partial success, but it is not a comprehensive success. Later on, that it has nothing to do with the akhirah. That's why the Quran condemns those who disbelieve, even if they are in terms of dunya, they have a lot of wealth. And Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, ولو أن أهل القرى آمنوا واتقوا لفتحنا عليهم بركات من السماء والأرض ولكن كذبوا فأخذناهم بغتة. Because people have disbelief, Allah Jalla Ala deprived them the baraka. And the baraka, my dear brothers and sisters, the baraka can be in your health, can be in your life, can be in your children, can be in your time. The barakah is one reflection of success. Those who disbelieve, they don't have the barakah, and they are not that successful. Anyway, let us go to the main point of this discussion. That looking after the parents, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, is a very key quality of success. Some people might say, how? Okay. Maybe I have mentioned this. I have mentioned this number of times, that I've been with a team of brothers and sisters writing a book called The Qualities of Success. And among the main qualities of success is number one, to have self-control. Number two is to be able to show love. Number three is to be able to network with others. Number four is to be thankful to people. These are among the key qualities. Now let us look at them. Your relationship with your parents needs self-control. Because so many of the young people, they are complaining that their parents are demanding this and that from them, and they cannot fulfill those. And once we say that, because they are the closest people to you, you need to exercise self-control. And no person can be successful if he cannot exercise self-control. Self-control, my dear brothers and sisters, is nothing but what we call in Arabic as sabr. Sabr. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اصْبِرُوا وَصَابِرُوا وَرَابِطُوا وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Oh, you who believe, show sabr, observe sabr, fight yourself in order to have self-control. Sabr is nothing but self-control. Remain firm, and then what is the outcome? لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. You might be successful. So this is sabr, self-control. The ability to show love. No successful person fails to show love. Even managers in big companies, if they cannot show their employees love, they will not be successful in securing their loyalty, and they won't be able to build a team, a strong team. In a family, can the family be successful if there is no love between themselves? They will fight among themselves. They will live a horrible life. Now, if you are able to show love to the entire world and you fail to show love to your parents, then this is a great deficiency in your personality, my dear brothers and sisters. So, the first people that you need to show love, of course, the parents will show love to their children, but you, the first people that you need to show love is your parents. And if you are living with your children and your children notice that you fail to show love to your parents, they will fail to show love to you. And once any family is deprived from love, they are deprived from goodness. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Aisha, "Alayki bir-rifq." Be gentle and show gentleness, because gentleness, once it is there in any small community, it will lead to success. And showing love, my dear brothers and sisters, is one of the sunnah that is missing in our life. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, "Ya Rasulullah, I love so and so." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, "Have you told him that you love him?" He said, "No." He said, "Go and tell him that you love them." And in the other hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "If you love someone, tell him that you love him." What do I need from you? I need you to show me love. If you tell me that you have love in your heart, but you don't show it to me, how am I going to benefit from this? How do I know that? Anyway, my dear brothers and sisters, showing love is a big subject. Okay, this is another quality. We mentioned also to be able to thank people. If you don't thank others, others will not thank you. The relationship will be weak between you and others. You will not be successful even in your business. Go to any shop, my dear brothers and sisters. Buy something and the person in front of you is rude. Even if his product is the best of product, you don't want to buy it from him. But if he's a smiling person, and he says thank you, and he said have a seat, and even if you ask him for something, and
he doesn't have it and he apologized in a very nice way, he will be eventually successful. You would like to come to him again and again. Imagine, my dear brothers and sisters, your mom, your dad, your mom used to clean your nappies. And as my father, rahimahullah ta'ala, have said, look at the amount of love that Allah ta'ala put in the hearts of a mother. Normally women, they feel disgusted from anything that is a bit unclean. My father, rahimahullah, may Allah have rahmah on all those who deceased, he said, look, the mother cleans the nappy, the defecation of her child, and then she goes and cleans her hands, and then with the same hand, she goes and eats. He said, wow, subhanAllah. Imagine this, how Allah Jalla wa Ala put the love of children and the care of children in the hearts of the mothers. And same thing the father does, but in particular the mother. And then when you grow up, you fail just to say to her, thank you, by your words and by your actions. And Allah Jalla wa Ala says in Surah Luqman, when Luqman was giving advices to his son, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حُسْنًا حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ وَانْفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ أَنِ اشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْهِ إِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرُ. Be thankful to who? To your creator, Allah Jalla wa Ala, and to your parents. Because without them, you could not be a human being, let alone to be an adult. So if you fail, my dear brothers and sisters, wake up. If you fail to be thankful to your parents, it is very likely that you will be ungrateful to any other human beings. Because there is no human being who has rights over you more than your parents. And then you fail to show them love. You fail to be thankful to them. And then you tell me that you can be a successful person. No way. Maybe for a short period of time, but not for a long period of time, not comprehensive success. So this is, and it is again a long subject, to be thankful to others. Another important quality that is reflected between your relationship with your parents. We said to show them, to be thankful to them, to show them love, to have self-control. One of the key qualities is to be able to network. The person, no person can be successful by himself. That's why our deen is based on jama'ah, unity. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Be united. And Allah Jalla wa Ala wants us to live in clusters, but not clusters against each other. Allah Jalla wa Ala wants us to look after our relatives. This is silatul rahim. And Allah Jalla wa Ala took upon himself in the hadith that whoever maintains the ties of kinship, Allah Jalla wa Ala will maintain ties with this person. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ قَاطِعٌ. The Jannah will not be entered by a person who cuts the ties of kinship. Now, if you want to maintain the ties of kinship with everyone except your parents, what kind of person you are? You fail to network. You want to be successful, my dear brothers and sisters. Okay. Now, these are just some elements to confirm, to show you that the relationship of your parents is a manifestation of or a reflection of your success in your life. We see, my dear brothers and sisters, that the Quran confirmed and the Quran assured the rights of parents in different ways. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited us from being disobedient or rude to our parents. In the Quran, we read Allah jalla ala in Surah An-Nisa, وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْعًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Worship Allah, don't associate someone with Allah jalla ala. And then immediately after Tawheed, be kind to your parents. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. The very famous verse that we read it frequently. Allah jalla ala decreed that you don't worship someone beside him. And then what? وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. You look after your parents. And we mentioned in Surah Luqman, not only that, Allah jalla ala says, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. Even to show them frustration. This is a big sin. Just to show them frustration, my dear brothers. Let alone being disobedient to them and rude to them and annoying them, let alone harming them. Just annoying them is a great sin. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the worst sin, shirk after shirk, is being an annoying person to your parents. عُقُوقُ الْوَالِدَيْنِ. To be disobedient to them to a level that you are annoying them without any justification. And even if you say that there is a justification, that has to be considered carefully, because Allah jalla wa'ala says in the Quran, وَإِنْ جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَنْ تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا. If they جاهداك from jihad, my dear brothers and sisters, they struggle to take you away from your deen, to associate someone beside Allah, to worship someone beside Allah. They were struggling to convert you, to change your religion. Allah jalla wa'ala said, don't listen to them, stay calm. Don't listen to them. And then what? وَصَاحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. In matters of relationship, be kind to them. Subhanallah. So no one can say that annoying them is justifiable. And my dear brothers and sisters, if we go to the life of the companion, the life of the successful people, the first generation, second generation, and we look at examples how they used to treat their parents. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his mother was a disbeliever, she was a mushrika, she wants him to leave his religion. And he was so worried about her. He went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah, my mother, she insults you and that annoys me. Ya Rasulullah, make dua for her that she accept Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raised his hands and he said, Allahumma hdi umma Abi Huraira. Abu Huraira went to his home, he found his mother accepting Islam. Allah. And he used to, whenever he used to leave, he used to take permission from her. Although he was going to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he used to make dua whenever he leaves and whenever he comes back to her. And in return, she used to make dua for him. One man came to Umar ibn al-Khattab. He said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, my mother is old and ill. And she cannot do the toilet except if she is sitting next to my back. Look at this situation. And then he said, once she finishes, I turn my face because I don't want to look at her aura and I clean her. Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, do you think that I have fulfilled her rights? Umar ibn al-Khattab said, what? Do you think that you fulfilled her rights? No way. When she used to clean you, she used to say, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, look after him so I see him as a man. And she wants you to live more. But when you clean her, you are disgusted. And you say, Ya Allah, when is this going to come to an end? Is this like that? Another person, Ibn Umar, he carried his mom from Yemen to Makkah, maybe 1,000, more than 1,000 miles. He saw Ibn Umar. He said, look, my mom, I'm carrying her and I'm doing tawaf. And I'm telling her that I like your house, or your horse, or your donkey. You are riding on my back. Do you think that I have fulfilled some of her rights? He said, you did not fulfill even a kick when you used to kick her when you were in her room. My dear brothers and sisters, we can go on and on. You need, please, brothers, please, I beg you to go and to hold yourself accountable regarding your relationship with your parents. And many of the young people, they come and they say, Sheikh, you know, my parents are evil, my parents and this and that. I am telling you, brothers, there might be some exceptions, but in general, wallahi, the easiest people to fix the relationship with is your parents. And if you say no, let me and I can fix the relationship between you and your parents in 5 minutes. I remember a sister coming to me and she was telling me, my father is this and that and this and that and this and that and I want to get married without his permission. I said to her, okay sister, okay, I want something from you. She said, what do you want, Chef? I said, I want you now to marry your father. She's 20 something, professional. I said, I want you to call your father now. And she said, what? Tell him that you are in trouble. You are facing some troubles and challenges. Put him on the loudspeaker. But pretend that you have troubles. And let us see. She said, yeah, he doesn't care. I said, sister, call him. Wallahi, I swear by Allah that she called him on the loudspeaker. And she pretended that she has troubles. Her father said, are you okay? Are you safe? Do you want me to come to you? I will come. Where are you now? No, tell me. This is the heart of the father, my dear brothers and sisters. The heart of the father will never turn to be a rock in front of you. Your heart is turning to be a rock in front of your father. Your father or your mother, they are the easiest, wallahi, the easiest to please. All what it needs from you is just some gentleness, self-control. Humble yourself before your parents. Don't show arrogance. And you will see that they are coming to you more than you are going to them. My dear brothers and sisters, it's a big subject. And it hurts me to see my Muslim community, especially the youngsters. We watch and we hope a lot from you, young people. You will be the leaders of humanity. You cannot be the leaders of humanity if your relationship with your parents is sour and bad. We don't want you to lead the humanity and you fail to lead a good relationship with your parents, my dear brothers and sisters. We lead the entire humanity by our morality and akhlaq. If we cannot show akhlaq and morality and good etiquette with our parents, are we going to show it to the entire world? No. We have superiority over the entire world, over the entire humanity, by worshipping Allah Jalla Ala and by, as Allah Jalla Ala described Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, by the high standard of morality and akhlaq. And this is the way we conquer the hearts of the entire humanity before we conquer them by power. In fact, the power of akhlaq overpowers any other power. And we want you, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, my dear youngsters, to master akhlaq. And Allah Jalla Ala sent us, Allah Jalla Ala sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to rectify the akhlaq of human beings. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، واشهد ان نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله بعثه الله رحمه للعالمين بشيرا ونذيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه ومن تبعه باحسان الى يوم الدين. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, many people say that okay, my parents passed away, I lost them. My dear brothers and sisters, there is nothing in Islam called I lost it. Islam wants us to be successful all the time. Islam is giving hope to all of us until the last minute of our life. Until not even the last minute, until the last second of our life. So there is always a chance. But they passed away. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the parent is the widest and the biggest gate to Jannah, and that gate has been closed. No, it was not closed. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, Ya Rasulallah, my parents passed away. How can I be kind to them? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, first of all, make dua for them. Make dua, my dear brothers and sisters, for your parents who passed away and those who are still alive. They will benefit from your dua. And maybe that is a sign of tawbah, that you regret that you were disobedient to your parents. So make tawbah to Allah Jalla Ala. Make a lot of dua. Give a lot of sadaqah. A man came to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, my mother passed away. I believe that if she was alive, she would have given sadaqah. He said, give sadaqah on her behalf. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, if the son of Adam comes, if he dies or she dies, all of his deeds, her deeds will come to an end except a sadaqah that is ongoing, or ilm that he participated in spreading, and a young person, a child who is making dua for him or her. So be that child who will make dua for your parents. So dua. Give a lot of sadaqah. And finally, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, be kind to those whom your parents used to be kind to. Be kind to your brothers and sisters and relatives, uncles, maternal uncles, paternal uncles, even to the friends of your father or your mother. May Allah make us among those who look after our parents.